Aloha, family and friends. Scott Sommer here with Sommer's Holistic Health Center, and I'm here to talk to you about how Chinese medicine was discovered and how Asian medicine, really the history of how it's different and similar to Western medicine. So let's begin. So basically, I found Asian medicine in a book while studying as a pre-med student, biochemistry at UC Davis. So ultimately, I ended up getting a degree in nutrition from UC Davis, but it was this book that I read in the bookstore at UC Davis, which was about Asian medicine. And I didn't realize until that point that it had been around for up to 3,000 to 5,000 years. And the way it was developed was really through observation. So the Asian culture in itself is a very observatory culture. They would observe things in nature, see how plants would grow, and that's how the herbal medicine started to grow and expand, as how herbs could help our bodies. Something called the doctrine of signatures, meaning if they found an herb that seemed to push water away, such as a water lily, then they realized that it would be helpful for the lungs, to get rid of fluid on the lungs for bronchitis. Just an example. Another way, part of Asian medicine is acupuncture. And so once they just started to discover acupressure points, the theory was is that the first acupuncture point that was ever discovered, legend has it, is that it was a man in battle that was leaning upon his sword. And then the edge of his sword, he had indigestion. And he realized that when he pushed on the acupressure point with the back of the sword, that he ended up resolving his indigestion. And so this is how, through observation and passing this information down, that this was discovered. Asian medicine was a process of 3,000 to 5,000 years. And we use this today because it is so effective still. No matter what condition you have, whether it be fibromyalgia, they still use the same type of terminology in a different way in the classics in a book called Yellow Emperor's Classic. So this is really the history of Asian medicine. And the other reason why Asian medicine is different than Western medicine, the separation really is, Western medicine really started with dissection. When they started dissecting cadavers, discovering the blood and what blood was about, and tried to do bloodletting, and there was a lot of experimentation. A lot of mistakes were made, of course, on both sides. But what happened was Eastern culture did not believe, they believed it was sacrilegious to even dissect the human body after death. So they had to rely on observations such as feeling the pulse, looking at the tongue, the color and the coating of the tongue, looking at the nails, the smell, the strength of the voice, the type of voice a person had, and even their personality, and even the hair and the skin and the nails, all had to do with an indication of what was going from the outside, representing the inside of the human body. So this is why I'm so fascinated with this, and that's really what got my attention and how I ended up studying Asian medicine for another 4 years after UC Davis. And then I went on to study kinesiology after that. And now I do my own research 20 years later. But what's so great about Asian medicine is that we have answers that Western medicine doesn't have. Many times there are not solutions in Western medicine. There isn't a drug that can help to deal with the symptoms, versus Eastern medicine deals with the cause of disease. So they're really two separate types of medicine. Western medicine works great for emergency medicine, but Eastern medicine is so much stronger for prevention and getting to the root cause of disease. So if you'd like some answers as to why you have the symptoms you do, why you ended up with a certain type of disease that you were diagnosed with in Western medicine, then Asian medicine is the answer. And I have a unique understanding of Asian medicine because my different degrees in nutrition, Asian medicine, and kinesiology, I'm able to assess your body in a different set of time and a different viewpoint, different than a naturopath, a chiropractor, or even an MD. So if you would like some answers to why you're not feeling well and how to get better the natural way, or we would say the ancient way, then come see me soon and find out more about our website, our membership site, and even attend a workshop. to take your health to the next level. I'll see you soon.